got Rich Macondo, executive of MTN Group Corporate Affairs, joining us on the line. Rich, where were you when you heard the news?
I was at home last night, and I was listening to 702, and there was this sort of a dedication to his life. And like Mrs. Mampela, I also believe that we should celebrate his legacy. And for me, his legacy is that of reconciliation, and is that of fighting for world peace. It's also a legacy of fighting for a prosperous future for all of the people. And this is what he fought for 50 years. And when he came out of jail after 27 years, he didn't relax. And he has not relaxed since. Unfortunately, illness took him away.
Earlier, Richard, I spoke to Russell Lobsher, the former CEO of the JSE, and he couldn't reconcile the emptiness that he's feeling right now. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling the emptiness, indeed, myself. You must remember that as a company, MTN is a child, is a daughter, is a sign of democracy, in that we were one of the first companies which were formed in 1994 after our election. And it is because of the democracy that we have in our country that we operate in 22 countries as we speak. And wherever we go, we carry the South African flag. Actually, MTN is the biggest South African-based company at the JSE. All the others that are bigger are actually operating from outside also. So we feel the emptiness. But also, as a journalist, as a former journalist who covered his release, and also covered the transition to democracy, I remember very well my interaction with him. What I remember most is that he wanted to make everyone feel special. And everyone who was around him felt he was special. And I was one of those who always wanted to make me feel special. For example, he would actually defy his spokesperson, Park Mankahlana, when Park said we shouldn't ask any questions. And he would say, well, let Rich ask one question. And he would sometimes meet me at a press conference and say, he introduced himself. And I asked him one day, why do you want to always introduce yourself? He said, because you need to be humble all the time. So what I take away from him is humility. He taught us that we all have to be humble. And when you are humble, your humility speaks louder than your actions.
Rich, as we move towards the 15th of December, when Madiba will be buried in Kunu, what are you expecting to unfold in South Africa?
I think I expect that all of us, deep down in our hearts, we would go back and look at what is it that I can take and use from Mandela's legacy. In my wall, as I'm speaking to you now, I've got 95 Mandela quotes to live by. So I think everyone should go and look at those quotes which were published in the newspapers on his birthday and just check one of them. And I just look at one of them and